the Board of Education meeting for Tuesday, June 20th to order. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay, first on the agenda is the approval of the agenda.
Move to approve the agenda of May 31st, 2017, regular meeting as presented.
Second.
Okay, the motion and the second, all in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, motion carries. Next, we have the election of the secretary.
I move to elect Terry McDaniel by acclamation as Secretary of the Board of Education for the 2017-18 school year.
Second.
We have a motion and a second, all in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, motion carries. Congratulations. Next is the appointment of the treasurer.
Move to appoint Sharon K. Share of First Bank of St. Genevieve as treasurer of the Board of Education for the 2017-18 school year.
Second.
We have a motion and a second, all in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, motion carries. Next is the approval of the consent agenda item.
Move to approve the consent agenda items as presented.
Second. Okay, a motion and a second, all in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, motion carries. Next, we have public participation. Moving right on to the report of the superintendent, Dr. Lynn.
Good evening, everyone. Have several items to report to you tonight. There is a note of appreciation that's in your board packet. Our favorite time of year is coming up. It's when the auditors come to visit. They will actually be here a couple different times. They typically come in July for what they call a pre-audit, and they're here for a couple days, and then they come back in September to complete the audit, and that usually takes 2 to 3 days for the second visit. So I always mark that on the calendar and look forward to that grand event. We've seen a lot of information about the storage cleanout. I'm going to include this as part of the summer maintenance housekeeping update. I'll start with the summer maintenance housekeeping. Things are progressing as we expect as far as the summertime activities. Getting floors done and some minor projects here on campus and a variety of things that are all on schedule and we'll certainly be ready to open the doors when school starts in August. So that's progressing nicely. The storage clean out, we've had a lot of items that we've set outside that were surplus property that people have come and got. We've had a good response to that. In addition to posting it on the district website, on the Facebook page, we send in emails to all the non-publics in our area, as well as all the school districts in AAA, to let them know that we had some items that they may have some interest in. We have had a couple of those entities that have come up and looked at some things. We had some things that felt like that it wasn't just surplus that we could we'd be able to sell, so we set prices for those and posted that information on Facebook as well, and so we've sold some items. It's taken about a week to get through the district storage under the middle school gym, and we've still got the PAC storage. So if people in our community are interested in items that we might have, we've pretty well gone through this facility, but we're just starting in the other facility. So there will be some items down there that will be for sale, and there will also be some items that will just be set outside and are free to a good home. So it's been a long time since we've done anything with that, and you know, just like you do at home, you accumulate things over time, and every once in a while you have to do a house cleaning. So that's what we're doing. But it's gone well so far. We've had a good response, scavenger hunted a few items here and there, but some of that stuff has been in there for 25, 30 years. And that's never, we've never had a need for it. So it was time to do something with it. Any questions on that? MSBA Fall Conference is on there. It's coming up October 5th through the 8th. So that's just on there as a reminder. Valor Bus Service inspection was successful again. They had 100% pass rate on their Missouri Highway Patrol school bus inspection. And considering that they have 39 buses and there was nothing found on any of them in any kind of a defect at all, is really a tribute to Mr. Jokers and the guys out, and the gals out at the bus shed. They just do a great job for the district. So we're pleased with that for sure. And I know he was as well. Also included in your packet, there's a summary of services that have been provided through school-based therapy. This is something that is fairly new to the district. We have a variety of students that have some needs that we just can't meet with our current personnel. So this was a partnership with community counseling to provide some of those services for those students here on our campus. And we've been pretty pleased with the partnership, I think. And as you can see from the report, there's been several students that have been served through that. Dr. Green, do you have anything you want to add to that?
Just that we're fortunate enough to get a second school-based therapist for next school year. So we'll have one serving both elementaries and then the other serving middle school and high school. Mm-hmm.
Any questions about that? Just felt like it was time to provide a summary of some sort, so you can see the impact of that partnership on our students. Pleased to announce that the Back to School newsletter, it's hard to believe that I'm already talking about Back to School stuff, the Back to School newsletter is just about ready to go and be printed and be distributed. What's our target date, Kathy? Mail out the last week in July.
We are anticipating arriving at the post office on Monday, the 17th, and going out to the public at 18th of July.
Okay. So coming up in about a month, then, will be the back to school newsletter, and they'll have the information in there with some, you know, sports schedules and all the back to school stuff, a school calendar, a variety of things. We hope people like the new format. It'll be the same kind of format as what we used this spring for the newsletter. And it will be done in place of what we used to call the summer mailer that went out. Yes. Yes. So we're looking forward to that. And Kathy Eisenbeis has really done a good job in pulling all that information together. And she frets and worries about it a lot. So we go through it and try to take some time and get everything the way that needs to be done. And part of the issue is the font kind of issues. And when you have so much information that you're trying to put, make sure that it's readable and pleasing to the eye. So I think we've made some improvements over the first newsletter that went out. So
that was great.
So we're looking forward to that going out, so the patrons of the district can look forward to getting that here in the next month or so. A couple of you I see came in carrying these alumni postcards. I don't have a postcard, I have a photocopy of a postcard. And we've had a couple phone calls from people saying, is this legitimate? And so we put some information out on the Facebook page and on the website to let people know that yes, it is legitimate. It's not really a school district function. This company is the same one that did the last alumni directory, which was about 10 years ago. Mm-hmm. And basically, they do these for schools and universities all across the United States. Because I know one of the proofs that they sent out, they had some information on, had Old Dominion University, and that was one of the universities that, they do business with. But basically, their business model is they solicit updates to alumni based on the prior alumni directory, and that's probably how these had addresses and those sorts of things. And so they seek updates to that information, and then they compile that into a directory. There's no cost to the district. It's really a service to the alumni of St. Genevieve High School. And then their business model and the way they make money is that they then market those directories to the alumni for them to purchase, so they have a copy. So that's basically what's going on with that. It's a company called PCI. I think they're based in Texas. So they're the ones sending the postcards. Yes, it is. Yes, it is legitimate. I'm disappointed that when they abbreviated Saint, they did ST period. But they had it right on the contract, so you would think that they would have had it right on the mailing. But that's their mistake, not ours. So if you have any questions about the, or if the public has any questions, obviously give us a call and, we'll try to set things straight. But we're trying to get some information out there to let people know that, yes, it is a legitimate card coming from a company that, has, you know, some sort of relationship with the district. So, I think that's all my report, unless you have questions.
Okay, then we'll move on to unfinished business. Can I see none? We'll move on to new business. First is the food service prices.
As you may recall, over the past several years, we've been required to increase lunch prices a little bit each year. That's based on federal law and a really involved calculation that we must go through to where we put in current prices and, a variety of other information. And then it tells us, yes, you have to increase your prices, or no, you do not. And for the coming year, we are not required to increase lunch or breakfast prices. And so my recommendation is that you leave the prices the same as they are in the current year.
That's good news.
Mm-hmm. I move to approve the following food service prices for the 2017-18 school year.
Second.
A motion and a second. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Next is addition of the chess club sponsor sign stipend.
Yes, we had a chess club that was formed. Was it 2 years ago? Mm-hmm. 2 years ago, the Knights of the Square Table, I believe they're called, and it has really grown leaps and bounds as far as interest in participating in that program. I think a lot of that is probably due to the energy of the sponsor.
Oh, sure.
We have a lot of students that are participating in it. We're in the process of developing some conference competitions in chess. So it would be very similar to the responsibilities for an academic team sponsor kind of thing. So I just felt like after 2 years and the growth and that it was time maybe that we include a stipend for that sponsorship. And, like I said, the stipend amount would match team sponsor amount. Dr. Taylor, is there anything you'd like to?
We kind of collaborated with the World Chess Hall of Fame, and they provided some stipends. You go and you attend two sessions, and that's what we've offered to the conference schools as well, letting them know that that's available so that they can send somebody. They provide you with chess boards and chess pieces, and you know, you get to take a trip up there. They're very accommodating. So hopefully we'll get a conference sport. If we don't get five teams, which will make a conference sport, then we'll just do some individual stuff. But last year we went to Windsor just as a, so sorry, Ricky Langham, just as a trial. They traveled with the basketball team and they stayed and watched the basketball game. And those kids just had a ball, so.
Oh, yeah. That's exciting.
I move to approve the addition of a stipend for the chess club sponsor for the 2017-18 school year.
Second.
A motion and a second, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Next, we have the budget for the 2017-18.
Yes, you have a hard copy of the budget there in front of you. Just so people understand, this is not the first time you've seen this document. You've had access to it for quite a while now in an online version. But felt like it might be helpful to you to have a hard copy here in front of you if you choose to go through it that way. If you don't mind, we'll just kind of work our way through the budget book. Kind of hitting the high points, anything that you have questions about, feel free to ask those questions. And then I'll ask for your adoption at the end. Before we really get into next year's budget, I want to talk a little bit about the current year budget. The last projection was done back in February and showed that we, the projection was that we would be using approximately $287,000 from reserves to support the district's activities for students for this year. My anticipated ending at the end of this month, the end of the fiscal year, is that we will be better than what was projected. That's due to a variety of things, but including some conservative projections on revenue, trying to build in contingency money on the expenditure side to make sure if there was something, some kind of major issue that came up that that we had money budgeted to cover that. So I think that we're going to come out better than what was projected. Still don't really know exactly where we'll be, but I'll have more information on that here in the next couple of months. As far as the FY18 budget, I want to talk first just briefly about kind of my basic philosophy with respect to school budgets. I feel like it's really a balancing act between providing the opportunities through programs and services for our students and being at the same time fiscally responsible to our parents. And so it's always kind of a balancing act with that, what's too much, what's not enough, that sort of thing. But that's really the basic philosophy is to provide those programs and services that our students need and deserve while also being responsible. So I feel like this budget does that. I went back and looked at our mission, and actually I put the mission on my notes here. The mission of the school district, which was adopted sometime within the last year or so probably, is working together to create success at St. Genevieve R2 and beyond. And our goal as a district is not to make money. Our goal is to provide opportunities for those students to be successful. And I think when we get into the middle of this budget, it really highlights all the kinds of things that the budget supports. We'll start with the book itself. Page one is a letter to you all that just provides a little bit of background. Page two is a summary of adjustments, additions, and deletions. As we've gone throughout the spring, we've added a couple positions, we've eliminated a couple positions. So all that information is in there, including salary adjustments, continuation of health, dental, vision, and life insurance. So all that information is in there and summarized on page two. One thing that it doesn't specifically say that in there, but we did have a fairly significant increase in health insurance, our health insurance premium. I think the original amount was about 14%, and we made some plan changes and did a variety of things to to lower that. In the end, the health insurance increase was about 7%. That's still a significant number for the number of employees that we have. So that's included there as well. All of the health insurance increase and, of course, dental, vision, and life insurance are all paid by the district. Those are not costs that are picked up by the employee. So, any questions on that page? Pages 3 through 9 really just provide some basic information that comes, for the most part, comes from state statute or from the Missouri Financial Accounting Manual that provides some framework and guidelines for the way that we have to put together a school district budget. So we won't go into any detail on that. Beginning with page 10 and going through page 157 is the section that I think I've referred to it as the "this is the why we're here" section, because it's all the accomplishments of our students, faculty and staff, administrators that are put into one place in the middle of this budget to make sure that we keep our minds focused on why we do this and all the programs and services that the budget supports, and then the accomplishments that come from that by our students and faculty and staff. So that information is in there. One thing I thought was interesting, and there's a lot of information in there, is that section is 55 pages longer than it was last year. So, yeah, there's a lot of information there. It's broken down by building. So you've got both elementaries and then the middle school and the high school. And there's really been a lot of positive things. We hear it every month during the school year when the principals give their reports. But this kind of takes all that information and puts it in one place. And when you do that, it's extremely impressive. So pleased to have that information in there for you as well. After that section, beginning on page 158 and going through page 161, are the various salary schedules. And that reflects what was listed back on page 2. It's just provided in more detail on those pages. Beginning on page 162 is the three-year comparison. So it compares all revenues and all expenditures by fund over a three-year period. It's probably more detailed than what you guys really want, but it is a required component of a school district budget. So it does give you an opportunity to kind of look over time and compare year to year if you choose to do that. Then beginning on pages 197 through 238 are the summary totals. Really, it's the same information that was in the previous section without the three-year comparison, but in a different format and then a little more detail. So if you cross-check the numbers, they match in the two different formats, but it's basically the same information presented in a different way. If you look at page 238, that provides the projections for revenues and expenditures in total for the coming year, the impact that will have on balances. Again, please keep in mind, my approach is a very conservative approach, and hopefully at the end of the fiscal year, if we haven't had major issues that have come up that have put some drain on our resources, we will finish them in a better position than what is shown there. So, debt service schedule is on page 239. Again, that's just a summary of your debt service obligations. Beginning on page 240 is a general budget summary. Basically shows projections for assessed valuation, for tax rate, and then also ending balances as of June 30th, 2018. So at the end of the coming fiscal year, those are your projected finishing balances. Those are subject to change after the FY17 budget year closes. And then the final page, that kind of brings everything together and shows a, let's see, a 28-year history of balances, historical balances back in 1990 to the present. Shows them broken out by fund and then also in total. Keep in mind, please, that the June 30th, 2017 is still a projection because we've not closed the year just yet. And then the June 30th, 2018 is the projection that's reflected in the previous pages, and of course will change as soon as the current fiscal year ends. So, a lot of information. I know you guys have had some time to look through it. Be happy to try to answer any questions that you might have. I feel comfortable with the budget, even though it does use reserves to a small extent. It's not, even if this budget was to come out and be exactly to the dollar the way it's projected, would not be a major impact on the district for sure. And I anticipate that potentially it could finish in a better position than what's shown.
What a big difference since 1990.
Oh, yes. Yes. Yes, absolutely. And you see, you know, if you look back historically, you see some places in there where the total balance is significantly higher than it was in other years. And if you look at those years over to the Fund 4 balance, you'll see that those are elevated, and that's basically when bond issue proceeds come in, they show up in balances in Fund 4 until they're spent to complete the bond issue project. So when you have bond issue projects that go over multiple fiscal years, it elevates that fund four balance, which in turn elevates the overall balance. In school terms, we refer to Fund 1 and Fund 2 as the operating funds, and that's really from Department of Elementary and Secondary Education. Those are the numbers that they look at to consider the health of the district. If there are concerns, it's based on Fund 1 and Fund 2 balances, not Fund 3 or Fund 4.
Dr. Lindsay, we were talking earlier today, and I appreciate that about the budget. And, I appreciate all the things that are done in those 100 pages, but also the budget itself. And we do that with, I think, one of the lowest tax levies in the whole area.
Yeah, if you, we looked at the information, it was about a year ago, I guess. Been consistently that way over a period of several years. But if you take St. Louis to Cape Girardeau, including all the districts in the St. Louis area and all the districts in the Cape Girardeau area, and you look at their overall tax rate, we have consistently had the second lowest tax rate of all of those districts. And there are a lot of districts, if you think up and down the I-55 corridor, include, like I said, all of the metropolitan St. Louis area and then down to Cape Girardeau. We have the second lowest tax rate of all. And honestly, I would put our facilities and our programs and services and the accomplishments of our students and faculty and staff up against any of them.
Absolutely.
That's from all of us.
Obviously, we, you know, I don't want us to ever take for granted the support that we enjoy from the community here. I think that's been vital to our success, and yes, there are other things that go into that, but I think being in a community that values education and supports their local schools is extremely important. So I think we greatly appreciate that.
Thank you.
There was a
$700,000 increase
in revenues that was from projection.
this is a reassessment year, so typically you see a little larger bump in assessed values in a reassessment year than you do in a non-reassessment year.
I appreciate your conservative approach.
Absolutely.
Because that keeps us where we need to be.
Right.
And I appreciate all the 155 pages, I found a lot, and a lot of your birthday, same day as my son.
Move to approve the proposed budget as the budget for the 2017-18 school year.
Second. I have a motion and a second, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Mr. McCaffrey.
I move that Board of Education hold a closed meeting with closed record and closed vote following the regular open meeting of July 18, 2017, to be held in the R.W. Thomas Library, 715 Washington Street, St. Genevieve, Missouri, for the purpose of discussing and voting upon the following items of business. Legal action, causes of action, or litigation. Lease, purchase, or sale of real estate. Hiring, firing, disciplining, or promoting particular employees. Proceedings involving the mental or physical health of identifiable individual. Scholastic probation, exposure, and graduation of identifiable individuals. Testing and examination materials. Welfare case of identifiable individuals. Preparation for negotiation with employee groups. Software codes for electronic data processing and documentation thereof. Specifications for competitive bidding until approved or published. Sealed bids and related documents until the bids are open. Sealed proposals and related documents until all proposals are rejected, or any documents related to a negotiated contract until a contract is executed. Individually identifiable personnel records, performance ratings, or records pertaining to employees or applicants for employment. Records protected from disclosure by law. Scientific and technological innovations in which the owner has proprietary interest. Records relating to municipal hotlines established for reporting of abuse and wrongdoing. Confidential or privileged communication with an auditor. Operational guidelines, policies, and specific response plans for preventing or responding to a critical incident. Existing or proposed security systems and structural plans of district property. The portion of the record that identifies security systems or access codes. Records identified would allow unauthorized access to or unlawful disruption of the configuration of components, the operation of a computer, computer system, computer network, or telecommunication network. Credit card numbers, personal identification numbers, digital certificates, physical and virtual keys, access codes, or authorization codes that are used to protect electronic transactions. I further move that notes in this meeting and the tentative agenda be posted as required by law.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Roll call, and Bob Rassen, David Bova?
Yes.
Joan Hook?
Yes.
Jim Kirchner?
Yes.
Harry McDaniel, yes. Martha Marie Singer?
Yes.
Rich Grunewald?
Yes.
Motion carried 6-0.
Move to go to a closed session with a closed record and a closed vote after a short break.
Second.
A motion and a second, all in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Thank you all for coming tonight. Hey guys, while, before you leave,